What is true of lawyers is equally true of citizens. In politics, as in law, it is best to treat opponents and their arguments with respect and serious consideration, even if that consideration is followed by reasoned and principled rejection. Well, having now harangued you for long enough on the need to treat counterarguments seriously and accord them respect, I will now immediately violate my own advice by making a claim to which I declare opposition to be impossible. Congratulations, class of 2016. You deserve it.
In an increasingly globalized world, we need lawyers, legal scholars, and advocates like you, collaborative leaders whose perspectives have been shaped by engaging with multiple points of views. Class of 2016, as you prepare to take up the next great challenge in your lives, know that your alma mater is deeply proud of you, and we look forward to all that you will achieve and contribute in the future. Congratulations.
If you don't like the way things are, or you just want to make your own life better, there's no need to follow the crowd and be an angry complainer. Get involved. Serve on the school board. Raise money for a charity. Teach a kid how to read. Run for Congress. Whatever you do, it will not only help you with your legal career, it will make you a better person and may even lead to greater things that you have yet to even imagine.
While graduation may mark the end of your formal education here at the law school, I urge each of you to stay connected with each other and with our law school.
So as we walk on stage today, then into the bar exam, then into our offices, I'm sure we will keep on changing. And we will keep on arguing. We will keep on fighting. But if you'll humor me, I have just one small thing to ask of my classmates, of all of you. Let's not change the way we fight. Let's not change the way we argue. Let's fight civil. Let's argue clean. At Buffalo, we learned a lot of things. We learned how to go into a courtroom and tell the judge respectfully, "Your Honor, I win here, here, and here, and if I don't, the other guy still can't win anywhere." Let's keep that going. Let's not change the way we fight. Let's fight clean. Let's fight civil.
The 2016 Ken Joyce Excellence in Teaching Award is given to a member of the adjunct faculty for excellent teaching and longstanding service to the law school. So with deep sadness that I present this award to John posthumously. John Nutorino was an extremely gifted lawyer, a wonderful teacher, a tremendous human being, and an unparalleled friend who is irreplaceable and whose teaching at UB Law School will bear fruit for many decades to come. Here to accept the Ken Joyce Excellence Award in Teaching on behalf of John is his wife and law partner, Catherine Nagel.
John truly felt he was privileged to be at the front of your classrooms at UB Law. He enthusiastically agreed to teach any class the law school needed. He spent countless hours with his bins of notes and materials to ensure that each class presentation would teach you what you needed, not just to pass the bar, but to be an effective attorney from the day you took your oath.
Today we welcome the members of the class of 1966 who are celebrating their 50th anniversary of graduation from the University at Buffalo School of Law. Mary Ellen Murphy Borgia, John A. Sarando, Marshall Cohen, and Richard Jackson. Would you please stand to be acknowledged?
The 2016 Max Gorin Award recipient is Nindras Jampier. The 2016 John N. Bennett Achievement Award is given to Stephen Mafucci and Bridget Steele. The 2016 Dale S. Margulis Award recipient is Amanda Karpovich. This year's Faculty Award goes to Professor Bernadette Gargano.
You may now move your tassels from the right to the left. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the class of 2016.